Mr. Todd.
At your service, sir. An honor to receive your patronage, sir.
Well, dear, looks like your governor has more often left you high and dry. Don't you worry. Your aunt may even think of what to do. Now come with me to be lovely back for that.
These premises are hardly prepossessing, and yet the beadle tells me you're the most accomplished of all the barbers in the city.
That is gracious of him, sir. And you must please excuse the modesty of my establishment. Only a few days ago I set up quarters here, and some necessaries are still to come. Sit, sir, if you please, sir, sit. And what may I do for you, sir? A stylish trimming of the hair, a soothing skin massage.
You see, sir, a man has touched wit with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and palm this stone, and let it be a more seductive tone, a sprinkling perhaps of French cologne. But first, sir, I think a shave.
Turpin, Joe, I ain't up with you. I shall offer up in some obscure retreat where
for neither you nor any other vile, corrupting youth shall ever see her again. As for you, Gardner, it is all too clear what company you have here. Service them well and hold their custom, for you will have none of mine.